Consider some examples where we are given to calculate time durations between two points of time. Here we have got one table and there are 1, 2, 3, 4 such problems where you are given start time, end time, and you have to calculate time duration. I suggest you to pause the video now and try for yourself and then check whether you have done this correctly or not. Pause the video now. Now let's see how we can solve such problems. Consider the first problem. Here the start time is 6:30 and the end 6:30 a.m. to be precise and 10:45 a.m. So 6:30 to 10:45. 6:30 a.m. First you should know that this a.m. means the morning time between 12 midnight or 00 hours to afternoon 12, and p.m. means from afternoon 12 to again midnight. This you should remember very well, midnight, and after midnight it becomes the next day. This thing is very important to know. So now the first question is 6:30 to 10:45 a.m. So the start time for the first problem is 6:30 a.m. Please imagine the clock in your mind. So from 6:30 to 7:30 is 1 hour or 60 minutes. From 7:30 to 8:30, it's another 1 hour or another 60 minutes. From 8:30 to 9:30, all these are in AMs. Please understand that it's early in the morning and then to late morning, 9:30 to 1 hour. 9:30 to 10:30 is another 1 hour. Now from 10:30 to 10:45, our end time is 10:45 a.m. It's not 11:30, but it's 10:45. So between 10:30 and 10:45, how much time have passed, you have to calculate. So 10:45, so 45 minutes and 30 minutes. So if you can imagine the clock in your mind, then you will be easily understand that during 45, the minute hand is at 9, 9 fives are 45, and during 10:45, the minute hand is at 9, and during 10:30, the minute hand is at 6, 6 fives are 30. So, and the difference between these two will give you the time duration in minutes between the two timings. This is for 10:45 and this is for 10:30. This time is for 10:30. So it's 15 minutes. So the total number of hours between these two times will be 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 hours, 15 minutes. Or it can also be written as 4 hours means 4 into 60, or 60 into 4 plus 15 is equal to 60 into 4 is 240 plus 15. You can consider calculating this, it's equal to 255 minutes. The more common way of writing is in hours and minutes. So it is 4 hours 15 minutes. So this is the answer to the first question. Considering the second example, the second example asks you the time duration between 7:40 a.m. which is during the morning, and 12:55 p.m. 12:55 p.m. same day. So this is a.m. and the end time is p.m. means this is during the morning hours and this is during the same day but after 12 in the afternoon. So what we shall do, we shall again jump 1 hour. So you can see that if you do, you can simply carry out minus 12 minus 7 is going to be 5. So 5 hours and it will be some minutes. The minutes will be 55 minus 40. So 55 minus 45, 5 minus 4 is 1. So 5 hours 15 minutes. Or you can have our, you can try our graphical way of doing that. Say 7:40 a.m. to 8:40, 8:40 to 9:40, 9:40 to 10:40, 10:40 to 11:40. We are jumping by 1 hour. 11:40, we are jumping by 1 hour, and then 12:40. So how many hours have passed? One. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hours have already passed, and then from 12:40 we have to go to 12:55. So these are PMs. All these are within AMs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So till this time we have got 5 hours, and then from 12:40 to 12:55 we have already done the subtraction. This is equal to 15 minutes. So the time duration is 5 hours 15 minutes. You can convert this into minutes also. You can multiply this 5 into 60 and add with 15 to get minutes. Coming down to the third example, it's asking you from 8:15 p.m. to 8:47 p.m. So you see from p.m. you can understand this is a timing during the night hours or late evening hours, because the timing falls between afternoon and the midnight. So from 8:15 to 8:47, the hours are same. You can see that the hours are same. So we need not to jump from hour to hour. We need only to consider the minutes. It's 15 here and it's 47 over here. So 8:15 to 8:47. So it's not complete 1 hour. So it's going to be 0 hours, and minutes we need to calculate. Here we have got 47, here we have got 15. So 47 minus 15 is 32. So 0 hours, 32 minutes is the answer. So here 32 minutes. Coming to the fourth example, so here you need to pay attention very well. It's asking you the time duration between day 1, 11:00 p.m. and day 2, 05:20 a.m. So this is day 1. This may be the time when somebody is going to bed, saying good night. So this is 11 p.m., 1 hour before midnight. And this is day 2, time to say good morning, while generally people wake up. So 5:20 a.m. This is the next day, and this is day 1, and this is the day 2. So now we need to calculate how we can carry such calculation. So 11 p.m. day 1, 11 p.m. will go to 0 hours, or 12 a.m. this will be 1 hour. From 00 hours or 12 a.m. exactly in the midnight to 1 a.m. You see that just after midnight it becomes a.m. and just before midnight it was p.m. This has to be understood very well. This will be another 1 hour, 1 to 2 a.m., 3, 4 and 5. So these all are a.m.s. These are during the late midnight. So a.m., a.m., a.m. So this will add 1 hour in each hops. Now after 5 a.m. it's 5:20. The last hop we have to measure is 5:20 a.m. So 5:20 a.m. So between 5 a.m. to 5:20 a.m. is definitely going to be 20 minutes. So how many hours are there? 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 hours 20 minutes is the answer. So, but during your exam, you definitely have to be much faster than these. because you need to calculate these things in your mind instead of writing this down. You should be able to count this in your fingers. So 11, 12 is 2 hours, 1, 3 hours, 2, 4 hours, 3 is the 5th hour, 4th is the 5th hour, and 5 a.m. is 6th hours. So 6 hours, 20 minutes from 5 a.m. to 5:30. The answer is 6 hours, 20 minutes. Now consider the last example given over here. It's between 9:47 p.m. It's somewhere during night to 10:22 p.m. Generally, students find it difficult to calculate such durations. So there you have to imagine the clock. So 9:47, you see that from 9:47 to 10. So this is 9, this is 10. But from 9:47, is it going to 10:47? If you are asked, so you can say that no, it is not 10:47, but it is somewhere in between these two. So this is not 1 hour. This is not completing. This is not completing. Completing 1 hour. 1 hour. So the timing will be somewhere between 0 to 60 minutes. So you should have to understand this first, that the timing, it is not exactly 9:47 to 10:47. Therefore, it is not 1 hour, not 1 hour or 60 minutes. You know, the time will be somewhere between 0 to 60 minutes. So how will you do this? First of all, you write down 9:47 and come to the nearest easier timing. Nearest easier timing means here the nearest easy to understand timing will be 10:00 p.m. And then from 10:00 p.m. you go to 10:22 p.m. So this is the transit time. This is the time, clock hour or clock timing, which is easy to understand. And therefore, you can take this as a junction point from where you can measure time on both the sides and add these two durations. Let us see how what I am trying to tell. So 9:47 to 10 will be exactly, so at 10 the minute hands goes to 60. So from 9:47 to 10 will be 60 minus 47. You see the clock ticks like this: 9:47, 9:48, 49, 9:50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 9:59, and then 9:60. And 9:60 means this 10 p.m. Okay, so at just 60 minutes and 47 minutes. So 60 minus 47 will be equal to 13 minutes. So on this side, left hand side of 10, we have got 13 minutes. Let me get a more space over here. And on the right hand side, it's 10:00 to 10:20 will be equal to 22:00. Nothing to calculate over here because it's starting from 10:00, going to be 22 minutes. So on the right hand side, we will be having 22 minutes. So the total duration will be the sum of these two durations. So 13 plus 22 will be equal to 2 plus 3, 5, 1 plus 2, 3, 35 minutes. So if you add these two, you will get 35 minutes. So from 9:47 to 10:22 p.m. will be 35 minutes. So I hope you have understood how to calculate time duration. It is very important to be able to calculate timings between two points of time. There are many questions in Olympiads, in NSTSE, in Silver Zone Olympiad. So you should practice this more and more. The best thing is to think of any two time, start time and end time, randomly, and calculate the time duration and get that checked from your parents or from your teachers. And you may also consider practicing these sums with decodemonk.com. Keep practicing. Thank you.